It's the dream of poker pro and amateur alike to win an EPT event.
Peter de Korver is the champion.
In six seasons, the PokerStars.com European Poker Tour has crowned 55 champions and paid out over 156 million euros in prize money to become the largest poker tour on the planet. And there's more up for grabs in San Remo this week as the remaining players duel for the title every player wants.
That's funny that has.
Stage is set for a drama of epic proportions as eight players take their seats at one table with over 3 million euros at stake. Who will take down the big money and the title of EPT San Remo champ? Will it be the loose cannon, the fox, the rookie, or will the chip leader take it down? A warm welcome to beautiful San Remo. Now, usually when I'm on the Italian Riviera, I'd refuse to be inside, but there are exceptions, and I think the final table of the largest ever poker tournament to be held in Europe is definitely one of them. The cream of the poker crop were on the Italian Riviera this week, and it wasn't for the ice cream. 1,240 players entered this season's event, a European poker record, and a 6 million euro prize pool was the result. Our winner today will take home a staggering 1.25 million, guaranteeing them overnight millionaire status. Time to meet the contenders for the title. In C1 is Claudio Bocchetti. The Italian doubled up late last night, much to the annoyance of Liv Barry.
How do you call a third of your stack pre-flop? I mean, it's just atrocious.
In C2, it's Alexei Rybin. The Russian has a cavalier style.
I'm worried. I can show you one for free and two for chips.
Can I pay cash now? It's an ace.
I'm ready to go all the way or bust pretty soon.
Bulgaria's Atanas Georgiev already has a fourth place EPT finish and is hoping to go all the way today.
My son watching the PokerStars TV, he's 3 years old, and he say, go, go, daddy, winner. This tournament is important for me because I missed his birthday to be here.
But he has the runaway chip leader to his left. Jacob Carlsen has 13.5 million in chips.
Feeling pretty nervous, but excited, I guess. I have a lot of support. I feel like a lot of people believe in me, I think.
In C5 is the table short stack Giuseppe Dieppe, who was the runner-up at the Italian Poker Tour Venice event earlier this year. In C6, UK pro and TV presenter Liv Barry is very excited.
Yeah, I got a little bit of sleep. A little bit jittery, though. Oh, I just can't wait. I just want to win it so bad.
This is Finland's Tony Pettersson's first live event, and he takes the 7 seat. Finally, in seat 8, it's Michael Piper, who can't believe his luck.
I've believed I can do it from day one. I just didn't expect it to happen. So, oh my God, final table. Yeah, I'm going to win this thing.
8 players, almost 3.5 million euros left in the prize pool, 1.25 million to the winner. Let's get to the action. Commentary comes from William Reynolds and James Hartigan.
12 months ago, William, you made this final table. Since then, of course, you took down the high roller events at the PCA. You are our resident poker expert, so I'm going to ask you to pick the winner.
I'm going to take the wild Russian, Alexei Rybin, with all of his bold moves and bold plays. He's not afraid to put chips in the middle.
Well, he is the wild card. He is quite a character. He is also one of the shortest stacks at the final table. He has 2.4 million. Giuseppe Dieppe is the shortest stack with 1.8 million. He's not going to play his king 5. Liv folds the king 9. Tony Pettersson with pocket 10s. Blinds 60, 120,000. He raises to 275.
Just realized who you look like.
Who?
Like Goose out of Top Gun.
Oh, so awesome.
With your aviators.
Yeah. I mean, I've been, there's a guy.
If we're going to play the Michael Piper lookalike game, I think more the 70s Vice Cop.
It's called. About
sounds about right.
Meanwhile, the action has been folded around to
Troopers.
Claudio Bocchetti.
Is that it?
If I had to pick a runner-up, I think I would go with Michael the Mustache Piper.
Alexei Rybin, I mentioned he was a short stack. He has moved all in with the ace-king.
In action right away to start this final table.
Pettersson has a stack of 5 million. Do you think he calls here with the tens?
It's only about 14 big blinds. He's putting his money in the pot.
Yeah, he does make the call. And we've seen a couple of kings folded, and that's why the percentages are as they are, 65%, 35%. And would you believe it?
Case king on the flop. Rybin in great shape now.
If it isn't 10 on the river, specifically the 10 of spades, then Alexei Rybin doubles up. He does double up.
And double up.
I have king five.
I have king nine, actually. Sorry.
Yeah, shoulda, woulda, coulda. We are still eight-handed as the final table continues here at the Sanremo leg of the European Poker Tour.
Welcome back to the PokerStars.com EPT, where action at the Sanremo final table has been fast and furious. After that hit before the break, Tony Pettersson welcomed a double up just a few hands later. It crippled Atanas, though, and he leaves the tournament €90,000 better off to buy his son a big birthday present.
Say happy birthday if you like right now. It doesn't have to be in English.
Happy birthday, my boy.
So seven remain, and it was all a bit much for Alexei Rybin.
You might be dead.
Do you want a coffee? Will you please?
Excuse me?
Get drinking.
With you?
It's all great. With
you. Should we do shots, everyone?
Yeah. Shots on table, we're all down.
I have bad English, but I can drink with you.
I think Liv's pulled.
So another big result for Atanas Georgiev. Fourth place in Warsaw in EPT5, and now eighth place here at Sanremo in Season 6. The blinds have gone up, 80, 160,000.
The 20,000 chip ante now. The ante is almost as large as the starting stack for this EPT Sanremo.
After a little bit of trademark shuffleage, Pichecki throws out a raise. The bumblebee chips are worth 100,000 each. The orange chips are 25,000. The blues are 10,000. So he's made it 325. Folded round to the big blind. The two homeboys taking each other on, the two Italians going to the flop. And Dieppe is not concerned about germs at the table, he's concerned about giving off tells. This is something we see Greg Raymer doing, covering up your face, your nose and your mouth.
Raymer has the trademark fossil glasses. He puts them on any time he is in a hand. And Giuseppe with the stop and go on this flop. He just called preflop and open jammed.
I guess that must have been the plan. I mean, when he called that raise from Pichecki, he did it for a significant percentage of his stack. As it is, he's connected here with bottom pair and the draw, the straight draw, the backdoor flush draw.
So it was a good flop to do it on. He's got a little bit of everything.
Pichecki, on the other hand, has completely missed and is forced to muck. So one Italian gets the better of the other. Meanwhile, Michelle has caught up with a Dutch poker legend.
I'm joined by a very well-known face on the poker scene. You could call him the James Bond of poker, if you will. Ooh. Marcel Luce, do you like that?
Yes, I like that very much, especially when you say it.
It makes a difference. What a beautiful place to be playing the final table of San Remo.
Yeah, it's more beautiful when you're on the final table, but I really enjoy being in San Remo in Italy.
Are you railing anyone in particular? Do you know any of the players?
I do hope really for Liv to make it, because she's working hard for a couple of years now and she really makes some results and she plays a very good game.
Excellent. Well, it's always a pleasure talking to you, Marcel. You're Thank welcome. You very much.
You're welcome. It's a pleasure.
So Liv Bari is in the big blind facing that raise from Pichecci. We saw a hand at the final table bubble where Pichecci raised it up with sixes. Liv re-raised with ace-king. Pichecci just flat-called and then hit a set on the flop. Liv shoved, having completely missed with her two overcards, and Pichecci snap-called and doubled up. That will be running through her mind right now, William.
I don't think we're going to see a three-bet out of Liv unless it's all in. She knows Pichecci likes to flat-call.
How much are you playing?
Well, Pichecci is the effective stack. He started the hand with 3.7 million. And I'm pretty sure that when Liv gets an accurate count, she's going to shove on him.
Liv's quite annoyed with Pichecci. I think she wants to dance round two.
I'm all in.
Yeah.
And the glim news for Pichecci.
Well, she asked him the question last time, had I shoved pre-flop, would you have called with your small pair? I guess we now find out what he does do when facing an all-in with a small pair.
No problem. King yesterday. I'll win, push, pocket six. I call. Oh, don't know. No. Oh, no. I pocket.
Pichecci is right. Liv does have two big cards, but he knows it's his tournament life on the line.
Okay, I fold. I'll play it.
She gets her revenge.
And Liv takes a nice one without having to see a flop.
Yeah.
Ace king, ace j, ace queen. Come on.
Spot on.
Well, either that or I have an overpair team.
Get it. Get it?
Or I can have nothing.
I don't know. Okay.
A disciplined fold from Pichecci then, but he was unable to get away from a pair of sixes just three hands later and left the tournament in seventh place. Chip leader Carlsen sent him packing and extended his already mighty lead. Carlsen continued to dominate until a monster pot against Pettersson a few hands later. He doubled the fin up, catapulting him into second place with a queen on the river. So Carlsen now with competition at the top of the table. The action didn't slow down. Two hands later, we were down to five. Dieppe, forced to push with 10 big blinds, found himself dominated by Michael Piper's tens, and it was arrivederci to our last Italian player.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.
So five remain then. Carlsen still leads, but Pettersson and Rybin look to be closing the gap.
Whoever goes out next collects €270,000. The winner will scoop €1.25 million. Line still 80 and 160,000. Michael Piper under the gun.
A little suited connector. Thinking about an under the gun steal here.
I'm going to try and remain objective and hide my excitement at having two Brits at the final table in the final five, but go England!
And Reuben picks up ace 10 next act.
Carlsen with jacks on the button. There is the four bet from Carlsen. He makes it 1.9 million.
Carlsen fighting fire with fire and three bets with four bets.
Now, Reuben gets creative with hands like three, four hearts, but Michael Piper quickly folds.
Carlsen showing a lot of strength with this four bet. We all know Reuben can be stubborn.
There is 4.5 million in the middle. Top pair for Reuben with top kicker. The overpair for Carlsen. This is where it gets messy.
Check.
He thinks he's trapping.
Check to trap.
And then fall into the jaws yourself when Carlsen makes the continuation bet. He sticks out just shy of 1.5 million.
That's one third of the pot. Carlsen forcing Reuben to make a move here on this flop. And Reuben's counting his chips.
How much?
1,460,000.
You know what he's like, William, he could well just shove this.
I'm all in.
He does shove it.
Alexei, re-raise, all in.
I call.
Carlsen has to call. And his jacks are good.
Alexei shows ace 10, so pair of 10.
Alexei has a saying, always an ace on the desk. He's going to need to see an ace or a 10 on the turn or river, or he's our fifth place finisher.
It's a queen. No help.
Same outs needed with one card to come.
One time, Slovenia.
Or an ace. Let's see the river card.
No ace this time. He is the man who collects €270,000 for finishing fifth here at EPT San Remo.
Easy come, easy go. Reuben gambled it up and gambled it out.
And his chips go across to the Swede as he walks to the rail.
The dejected look on his face.
Carlsen now has close to 20 million. His stack went up, then it went down, and now it's gone up big time.
Down to four then, and just five hands later, another one bit the dust. Short stack Michael Piper raised all in with Queen 10, only to get called by Carlsen sitting there with Ace King.
Look,
you need it more than I
do. I don't think you mean that. You should touch your sweater.
Oh, yeah.
There we go.
So going to the flop, Piper was dominated.
Sure, well, look. You're going to read it out anyway, aren't you?
Oh.
And it only got worse.
King of spades. See the turn card,
thanks.
And a blank on the turn sealed his fate. So Piper comes up short, but takes home €345,000. Not a bad payday at all. Just three remain then, and Carlsen is looking unstoppable with 19.5 million in chips. Pettersson is second with almost 12 million, while Liv has just half that amount. So it looks to be a battle of the boys, but can Liv achieve the unimaginable and beat them both to come out on top?
Liv, the last remaining Brit, now that Michael Piper's hit the rail.
Piper's out of sight, out of mind, out of chips. My number one and two picks have just hit the bricks.
We're not going to ask you back now.
All right, Liv with some pocket eights here.
Yeah, the blinds have gone up, by the way. We're playing 100, 200 now. Liv starts the hand with 6 million in chips.
She is the short stack three-handed.
She raises from the small blind.
Nice sized raise out of position here with a pair of eights.
Tony Pettersson looks like he's gonna very quickly re-raise with king queen. A very quick all in and a very quick call.
And here we go, off to the races again.
Queen.
Tony Pettersson got very lucky with a queen on the river in a previous all-in confrontation. Saw him take the chip lead from Jakob Karlsson. And I believe that was against pocket eights as well. And that's why Liv is feeling the pressure. Also, her tournament's on the line right now.
Flop comes. Three of diamonds,
come on,
five
queen.
Of clubs, Jacob spades.
Liv can be happy about this one.
I think she'll be happy when the river card's dealt and they're all blanks.
Eight.
Two cards to come. Both players calling cards. And Pettersson picks up the gut shot.
Ten, a king or a queen for him to eliminate Liv. But it's the eight that she called for. I'm sure she's a little bit frustrated that it was the eight of hearts rather than the eight of diamonds. That's the one she wanted. But she'll take it.
She'll take it nonetheless. She found the double up button.
I think I had like 6 point something. I don't know.
Well, the situation switches. She now has a stack of 12 million. Pettersson now the short stack with 6 million.
Welcome back to San Remo for the penultimate final table of the PokerStars.com EPT Season 6. Jacob Karlsson has a monster chip lead after taking out Alexei Rybin in fifth and Michael Piper in fourth place, respectively. But Liv is on the move after just doubling up through Tony Pettersson. Three remain, but who will triumph in season six? Well, let's ask the man who won here 2 years ago.
Joining me is professional poker player Jason Mercier. And Jason, do you know any of the players left?
Yeah, I know. Well, I played against the Finnish kid on day three, and I played against the other two people. I played against Liv a decent amount and talked to her a lot, and Jacob, I played against him online a lot.
Who would you put your money on?
Probably Jacob, but I heard that Liv has been playing really
very well.
Yeah, and she hasn't even been all in until the recent coin flip that she just won, so... You know, when you're in the zone, nobody can take you down sometimes.
You're in the zone, you're in the zone.
Yeah, exactly.
Fantastic. And we'll see you in Monte Carlo.
Thank you.
Yes, the grand final is coming. There is the small matter of crowning a champion here in Italy first. Carlson's folded the button. Liv with the decision, with sevens in the small blind.
Looks like she's going to raise it up again while the deck's going her way.
Well, I thought she was going to do the same, William, but she's just called.
Limped. She's mixing it up.
Pettersson elects to see a free flop. So she raises with eights, but calls with sevens. Trying to trap. Oh, she's fallen into her trap because Pettersson has flopped a house.
A house built by 6-4 suited.
And if you're looking at that board and you've got pocket sevens, you're thinking, I'm happy.
Pretty comfy with an overpair here. She's gonna go ahead and lead out.
Liv bets 275,000.
And let's see if Pedersen just gets sneaky and calls, or he might decide to juice the pot with a raise.
If he could see her hand, he certainly would raise. He gives her credit for something because he's pumped it up.
He is putting Liv on a hand at this point. Now Liv's thinking, why did I just limp preflop?
All in.
Cool.
Liv announces all in.
Misstep.
Wow.
She's just doubled up through this guy, and now she's about to double him up.
Bit overplayed in this limped pot.
What is that?
Tony shows four of clubs, six.
That's a full house.
Rigged.
He flopped full house, fours and sixes.
Seven?
Liv's hand is pocket seven. Seven of hearts.
Seven
of
clubs.
Maybe overplayed there, James.
She knows she needs a seven.
Ace of hearts.
Seven.
It's the only card that would see her make a bigger full house and eliminate Tony Pedersen.
No help for Liv, and Tony will
a flush, no good against his full house. They switch again. Liv down to 8 million. Tony up to 11.5 million. The word I would use is yo-yo stacking. Riding the roller coaster is our Miss Bury.
That's just funny, that hand. I was like, please have a six. Yeah. Oh, we had a six.
Slightly warped sense of humour. Not sure I'd be laughing if I was in her spot.
Easy come, easy go for Liv, but over the next 17 hands, she favoured a more methodical approach and gradually built her stack up to 11.6 million, a fraction more than Pedersen, and earning her the second spot.
There's previous EPT winner Tanduk Win in the middle there, finished 18th here in San Remo. Blinds up to 125 and 250,000. Pedersen raising the button with King Queen.
And Liv picks up a pair of threes here in the big blind. It's only going to cost her 350,000 more to call. They have almost 50 big blinds. She might see a flop here.
She has been playing a very aggressive game, though. Calling doesn't seem to be part of her modus operandi.
Well, she's thinking about a three bet, trying to take it down.
What do you have, about nine?
Sometimes the best defense is a good offense. Liv taking the aggressive approach, reaching for chips.
The re-raises to 1.5 million.
1.5 million. I'm not quite sure whether this is a poker game or a stare-out duel. Whoever blinks first forfeits the pot. You lose.
So tense at this final table. Pedersen with the call.
Decides to see a flop in position.
3.2 million out there.
Oh, dream flop for Liv Bury. A set of threes, top pair for Pedersen.
Pedersen in bad shape, picking up top pair with a good kicker in a three bet pot.
She had the betting lead pre-flop. She is going to continue. what price Pedersen comes over the top.
Looks like no slow playing here. And she bets 1.5 million, half the pot. And there's no question all the money's going in. Is it going to be on the flop or the turn? If I was Pedersen, I would just call here and let Boree maybe fire off some bluffing barrels, but he elects to min-raiser.
Faced with that raise, what should she do?
Pedersen's committed almost half of his stack at this point. Think she is going to move all in, thinking Pedersen's going to call.
That's what she does.
Lebanon's is all in.
Call.
Cool.
And he makes the call. She shows the set of threes. Pedersen with just a 2% chance to survive. Runner needed for the Finn.
Three of hearts, three of clubs.
Liv in great shape here.
Pedersen resigned to his fate. He's drawing dead on the turn. He will be our third place finisher. He will collect €420,000. He's played a great game and should be proud of this finish in his first ever live event.
That was a dream flop, yeah.
And Liv can't quite believe that she is in the final two.
Liv goes into the heads-up battle with Lady Luck on her side and a 2 million chip lead after an exceptional comeback.
Why is Mike laughing?
But the tough young Swede won't be going down without a fight. With three EPT caches already to his name, Jacob wants a title to add to his collection. Will we have a king or a queen of San Remo?
So the stacks are pretty even, and here we are going to sweat with Jakob Karlsson, playing the hand from his perspective, only seeing his hole cards.
Take a race.
King 8, enough for him to raise the button.
We might see some fireworks here. They're heads up for the largest ever EPT title.
So Liv has made the call. I think it's fair to say she does this with a pretty wide range, William.
She's willing to see the flop, heads up. Karlsson picks up a pair with a king high kicker. It's a very dangerous board though. Three clubs and he doesn't have one. He's probably gonna bet here to protect his hand.
Exactly what he does.
1.2 million in the pot, and he decides 700,000 is the magical number.
The stare out contest continues. Having got the better of Pedersen, Liv's now going to take on Karlsson. As far as the poker game is concerned, she will just call.
Okay.
What do you reckon? She's got a club in her hand?
Some type of mid club with maybe a pair of nines. Well, if she has a pair of nines, she's in bad shape now. Karlsson makes trips on the turn. His king eight keeps looking better and better. 2.6 million in the pot.
But I guess he has to bet again in case she does have a club and is chasing that flush.
He can't slow play at this point. Liv's shown she has some type of hand by calling the flop.
$1.6 million.
Right around 60% pot. I like this bet a lot out of Carlson. It's too small for her to fold a nine. And she's reaching for chips right away.
I don't think she's reaching for chips for a call. I think Carlson's about to get check raised. Is it possible that she has just two random clubs in her hand and actually flopped the flush?
She could be if she's going for the re-raise here.
$2 million on top.
And Carlson faced with the decision now. He knows he has the eight. What does Liv have? This looks like a great spot for Carlson to just call. They're pretty deep to start the hand, and not many worse hands can call him if he moves all in with King 8. Only a few 8x combos that are worse than Carlson's King Kicker. Liv showing tremendous strength, and there he is. He announces he's all in.
I guess his read is, you have a club and I don't want you getting there on the river.
And Liv slouching in her chair a bit. She looks a little bit dejected here. A bluff re-raise might not have worked.
I think it's safe to say she doesn't have the made flush. Clearly got something, unless this is just Hollywooding.
Liv attempting to be the conquistador of check raises, but she mucks her hand there, and she was bluffing with just the queen of clubs. She tried to represent that eight on the turn.
So she was on the draw. Carlson priced her out of drawing, and he put some distance between them. He now has 22.5 million. She has 14.7 million. He made a good read, and he followed it through with strong play.
So we're heads up here in San Remo. Join us after the break when the Barry versus Carlson battle for 1.25 million euros will resume. Welcome back to the European Poker Tour from San Remo, where we're heads up at the largest tournament ever held in Europe. Before the break, Carlson took the chip lead, but he struggled to hold on to it for long. He lost two consecutive pots, totaling 11 million, clawed a bit back, and then lost this monster to Liv. Jacob hit his ace, but the five on the turn completed Liv's straight, and 10.7 million was shipped her way. Then followed a more cautious period, and as we enter the 100th hand of play, Liv is almost 24 million compared to Jacob's 13.4.
Claudio Pichetti in the audience, shuffling no more. Eliminated from the tournament in seventh place. His nemesis still at the table. Now she has the chip lead.
Almost 100 big blinds. That's a lot of chips for tournament poker this late. And Carlson has a pretty good hand on the button. The K9.
Take a raise. 525.
A little over a min raise. 525. Pocket threes have been a good hand for Liv Barry. She flopped a set with them against Tony Patterson.
She three bet them last time. See what she does this time. Mixes it up and takes a flop.
Here's the flop. Flop comes four diamonds, ten of
is a fairly dry flop that misses Carlsen. It only helps 10-7 suited to ace-10 and any type of diamond flush draw. I'd expect a c-bet.
John Aguiar and Greg Dyer, two young guns of the game, watching from the audience.
Jacob bet. 600.
There is the continuation bet from Carlsen.
Now Liv has a decision to make. She can maybe check raise this and try to win it now, or just call and play a guessing game.
I have to say the first option sounds more appealing to me.
Makes the hand a lot easier to play.
Liv call.
But oh. She's gonna check call.
She's opted for the guessing game, William.
Turn cut, six cards.
That gives her a gut shot straight draw to go with a pair of threes. Still no hand for Carlsen other than king high.
And he checks it back.
Wow, she gets there.
Liv rivers the straight. Deuce to six. See if she decides to lead out here. It's 2.3 million in the pot. She might be thinking Carlsen picked up a six on the turn and checked it back.
$1,500,000.
She slides out a big bet. The only way Carlsen could call this is if he put her on some type of busted diamond draw that does not have a pair. It's only a few combos of hands.
Hang on a second.
He's not looking to call.
No, he's not going to make a hero call with king high. He's going to raise.
And he's trying to represent that three, but Liv has two of them.
Oh dear, his timing is way off.
I like this raise out of Carlsen. He checked back the turn. It would put Liv in a tough spot if she didn't have the three.
What does she have behind Jacob?
But she has two. It looks like she's actually debating if she's going to re-raise this.
9? 8-4.
Wow, she does shove on Carlsen with the three.
You've been caught.
Take her pass and Nick takes her.
She must not have been worried about the 7-8. I don't think she wanted her threes to go to showdown.
She now has a commanding lead over Jacob Carlsen. He is on the ropes.
31 million to 6.4.
Liv's railing crew is getting excited, but they're keeping that excitement on the inside.
Now the blinds have just bumped up again, 150,300,000. Jacob starting this hand with just 21 big blinds, and Liv Bari with over 100.
And she's got a pair.
And we shouldn't see any more limped pairs from her pre-flop. I think she learned her lesson with the pocket sevens.
There's the raise, a total of 700,000. Ace six for Carlsen. And he moves all in.
Re-raise, all in.
How much more, please?
And Liv getting an exact chip count to make sure it's not a little out of her calling range.
When you take the stack sizes into consideration, William, is it an automatic call with the fives?
With 20 big blinds, Jacob could be value shoving worse hands. He's going to be shoving any pair, a lot of ace X's, and pocket fives have more than enough equity versus that range.
Oh, cool.
She's reached the same conclusion.
Showdown.
And it's actually pretty much a coin flip, the two over cards against the pocket fives. Now remember, the winner gets 1.25 million, the runner-up 750,000. They're flipping a coin for €500,000.
And more importantly, the largest ever EPT tournament on European soil.
That title, that trophy, it means so much to both of these players. Liv Bury is on the verge of being crowned champion. If those pocket fives hold up, there are five cards to come.
Five, please.
She doesn't need to see a five. She just needs to avoid the ace or the six.
And here it is. Eight of hearts, king of spades, ten of diamonds.
No ace on this desk.
She is now a 70-30 favorite. Carlsen needs that ace or that six on the turn or river, or we have a champion here on the Italian Riviera.
It's a seven.
And Carlsen picking up a gut shot now. Four more outs.
Any nine, any ace, any six.
Any other cards?
Those are his outs.
Let's see the river.
The river. It's a blank. Liv Bury has done it. Jacob Carlsen's the runner-up. Liv Bury is the champion of EPT San Remo. €1.25 million.
Liv Bury, how does it feel? EPT San Remo champion. Oh, I can't even speak. I don't want to cry because that's not professional.
And no, cry. I'm crying and I'm working. It's fine.
I can't believe that I've won this. This is incredible. It's so weird. I felt like I was gonna.
Liv, you said this morning you were gonna bring your A game today. You did it.
Yeah, Yeah, I really did actually. I'm kind of surprised. I just, like, everyone today played so good. I mean, Jacob was amazing. He was the one person I didn't want to get heads up against. I was like, oh God, really him? Because I mean, he's a legendary online player. He's so good. But yeah, I mean, I just ran well, obviously. I played good. It was just, you know, one of those things.
Yes, she is a friend of mine. Well done, Liv. Great performance from the runner-up, Jacob, as well. He gets a not-too-shabby 750k for his efforts. A fantastic final table for the penultimate leg of Season 6. For now, it's time for Liv to lift the trophy with pride. Huge congratulations, only the third woman ever to win an EPT. Incredible achievement here in San Remo. Time to say goodnight from myself, James and William. See you in Monte Carlo for the PokerStars.com EPT Grand Final. Ciao.